Hello everyone. So today I am here to continue with our topic, kings, powers and towns. Today in this topic we are going to learn about various economic activities that were carried out during our period of study. So the major economic activities that were carried out during this period were agriculture, trade, and of course, pastoralism. Now, we all know, agriculture refers to growing of crops and plants for our daily consumption as well as trade. Trade, exchange of goods and services, and pastoralism refers to rearing of animals for domestic as well as for trade purposes. Now, the most important economic activity during this period was agriculture. This was a period when agricultural production was increased. And to increase this agricultural production, they employed certain strategies, new innovations, which helped in increasing the agricultural production, specifically rice and wheat. So what were these strategies? What were these new innovations? Let's talk about these. Strategies to increase agriculture production. Now, the very first activity was, the very first strategy was use of Arabian country, countries and China and Southeast Asian countries. For this external trade, two types of foods were used, sea roots as well as land roots. Land roots included the entire Indian subcontinent and the Silk Route. Silk Route connected India to China as well as Arabian and European countries. It was entirely the land route and it was a fairly impressive trade at that time. Secondly, the sea routes. Sea routes connected India to Arabian countries. Southeast Asian countries. And of course, China. Remember, the five major administrative centers of modern empire were on either the Silk Route or the Sea Route. For example, Taxila, Ujjain, Patliputra. All these three were on the Silk Route, that is, the land route through which trade was carried out. While Kalai was on coastal area, so it was linked to the forest, the sea trade. So, this was the trade routes. There are two more things which are worthy remembering. That is, trade was carried out not by individuals, but by the associations of the traders. These associations were called guilds, G-U-I-L-D-S. These guilds provided for finance, shipping, movement of goods and services, insurance, and of course, the goods. Because guilds were also associated with the artisans like the blacksmiths, goldsmiths, carpenters, and others. And second thing, what were the goods that were exported? India at that time exported spices, cotton textiles, gems, and medicinal herbs, medicinal plants. And what was imported? Imports included horses, gold, and wine. These are the major items of imports, that is, what we bought from the external countries, from Arabia or from Roman Empire. Last economic activity was pastoralism. Pastoral communities in this period reared cattle like cows and buffaloes and smaller animals like goats and sheep. These animals were reared for their milk and milk products, wool and other animal products. These animal products were traded with the townspeople, and basically pastoralists have not left any kind of records about their interest. So not much is known about their social or other aspects of their lives. So this brings us to the end of our topic today. Go to the description of this video. There is a link given. When you click on it, you will find an assignment worksheet which you need to send on your WhatsApp groups. Thank you.